It's very flattering, actually, and very surprising. I mean, the Broadcasting Press Guild, that's the writers and critics. These are the people with the teeth, as it were, with no other agenda than looking at quality. So to have been nominated was fantastic. I have to say, very much a testament to Charlie Russell, the gentleman I made the film with. I've spent the last 35 years making television programmes about creatures that are far more interesting than me, and then finally someone makes a programme about me and it's up for awards. So I'm a bit disgruntled, to be quite honest with you. On review of my previous work, all of those fascinating species of animal are far more interesting. Jesting aside though, the programme has had an enormously positive impact. That's been the most heartening thing. I've had a response from the autistic community and their friends and families and teachers, from the psychotherapist. I mean, across the whole spectrum of society, people have been really pleased that someone has spoken candidly about it. It seems to have made a difference, and that's what I wanted to do when we set out. One of the things that I was, you know, insistent about at the outset was that this programme would represent an opportunity to talk about the abilities rather than the disabilities. I don't think of myself as disabled. I think of myself as enabled in some departments and compromised in others. And I wanted it to be very much a case of saying, you know, we have a skill set, we have certain abilities that perhaps other people don't have. The other thing I really wanted it to do was to offer hope to young people. The most uncomfortable, the most difficult times are throughout the end of childhood, adolescence and early adulthood. That's when things can be really, really dark and difficult. And I wanted people of that age to look at this and think, well, if I get through it and I learn how to manage myself and I work with therapists, so on and so forth, there is an opportunity that I can live a fulfilled life and play a pertinent role in society. We are, as a species, cruel when it comes to difference. You know, we have a history of racism and homophobia, and these are being addressed. We haven't completely solved the problem. But we also pick on people who are mentally different. And it's something that has to stop, because it's that diversity of our species, our race, our sexuality, our gender, and our cognitive abilities, which makes us what we are. It's an essential component of our species, and it should be something that we celebrate and not persecute. And I think we're only going to achieve that if we talk about it. And we've talked and made progress with those other problems in society. And now it's time for mental health and cognitive differences to be spoken about openly so that people can think about it, learn about it, and adjust their behavior. And ultimately, that's what we want. We just want acceptance of difference, because I'm not disabled, I'm just a bit different, that's all.